Friends, welcome to yet another session of NITCO Talks. Today, I would like to welcome two gentlemen who need no introduction, Dr. Niranjan Hiranandani and Hafiz Contractor. They have transformed a barren land into a fantastic township. I remember I invested there when the construction first started at 425 rupees a square foot, because I was also friendly with Niranjan's brother, Surendra Hiranandani, and he was handling sales as well. So because of the friendship, you know how real estate is, it's all relationship driven. So I was buying and investing in the complex in Pavai at 425 rupees. The prices there, guys, are today 45,000 rupees per square foot. If I had just held on to the 50,000 square feet of area that I had bought, I would not need to work anymore. Pavai is so much in demand that many of Bollywood movies are shot over. Well, without much ado, I would like to ask Mr. Hiranandani to tell us how he managed to get 250 acres of prime land right opposite the Pavai Lake and the vision he had to convert it to prime real estate. Over to you.
Yeah. Thank you, Vivek. Thank you for inviting me and also along with Hafiz, the architect, the creator, the humblest creator of all, Mr. Hafiz Contractor. So happy to be with him actually on this platform, because he'll be able to tell you as much as I can, if not more, about so much that we have done over there. Because at the end of the whole thing, it's always the design and the creation that really he did. We actually executed it. But Vivek has always asked me this question as to what is Pavai and why Pavai? First of all, why Pavai? And then what happened and why do you really wanted to go to Pavai of all the places? At least in those days when it was so far away from the madding crowd. The story goes somewhere like this, and I'm trying to make it into a complete story because the reality could be a little more complex. The story goes like this, that I went and built 11 buildings in Lokhandwala complex. That was, and I couldn't, it was 11 plots, 1 lakh square feet each. And I used to buy those plots one at a time because I couldn't afford to buy all the plots together. And that also we would get part of the FSI and I would pay it by installments and stuff like that. But after I completed each building, and when we went into the buildings and we looked out of the buildings were nice, they were good, they were different. But the problem was when I looked out of the window, everything was horrible. The access roads were not tarred. There was no good water supply. The streets didn't have lighting. There were no stormwater drains. And more behold, there was no sewerage connection. There were septic tanks and soak pits which were there. And it was just horrible. And I couldn't understand why this large complex called Lokhandwala complex should be so dirty, so horrible when you looked at the environment around you. So made one building, two buildings, three buildings. Then I formed an association. It was called the Summer Developers Association. Mr. Shiraj Lokhandwala, who owned 150 buildings over there, became the president of the association. Mr. Walawarkar, who was the seller, became the chairman. And I became the humble secretary. And we constructed the roads, the stormwater drain, the sewerage, the garden, everything. And we did all that in this small association. And it was difficult to collect 4 rupees a foot from all the builders to provide water supply, sewerage line, stormwater drain, street lights, and everything. And this really disappointed me, because every time you completed a building, can you imagine if the environment was terrible? So in the back of our mind was one day to go to a place where you not only make the buildings, but make everything around the building. Of course, didn't have an idea of what kind of creation that we wanted to do. But the idea was basically to see how can we do the everything in a complex. Because we couldn't rely on the local government, the corporation. We couldn't rely on the other builders. We couldn't rely on anybody for doing a good job, at least at that point of time. Now, many of the builders are so wonderful. They do a fantastic job in many of the places. So we started looking for some lands. And I came across, and obviously I wanted a large piece of land simply because I wanted to do everything that was possible in that place. We came across Pawai. Pawai had multiple problems. A, it was badly located. It was far away located. It was a quarry land, so it looked terrible. It had all khajans and all. In the entire 250 acres of land which existed over there, there were 20 trees, which hardly looked like trees. And the rest was just a horrible piece of place, though there were a few mango trees. And the entirety was quite sad. But there were two advantages. I was getting it at a reasonable price, very, very, very reasonable. And I was getting it in installments because the landowners were in the need of money. And second, there were problems regarding urban land sealing. There were other problems which they were not able to sort out. They had gone to Dr. Baker, they had gone to Raijas, and everybody threw them out of the office saying that what a location it is. We are not interested in something like Pawai. So that's how it landed up in my lap, simply because. And the first amount that I paid was 10 lakhs of rupees. And believe you me, I had to borrow it at 2% interest per month. So that was the beginning of Pawai. And that's how I started it. I'm going to go on a little fast forward as to what it is, because a lot is going to be told to you by Hafiz. And he's a better person in this respect to share with you. There were two or three things which were always there in the back of my mind as to what we really wanted to do. One, that I was brought up and I was very fortunate that I was son of a very famous doctor, Dr. L. H. Hiranandani, an ENT surgeon. And though I was doing commerce and I wasn't at that point of time the favorite, he still, you know, kind of supported me in whatever it is. But we had very little capital to get into the business. But I had an advantage. I stayed in Malabar Hill. I studied in Campion School. I studied in Sydenham College. And so I was staying in one of the best areas of Mumbai. That was the biggest advantage that I had when I grew up. And what did I think? I thought in Pawai, we must do everything and make everything which should be better than my house in Malabar Hill. So the first thought process was, whatever we make in Pawai should be better than Malabar Hill. So there is Hanging Gardens and Kamala Nehru Park over there, which was very, very famous at that point of time. And I decided that the gardens we make in Pawai will be better than Malabar Hill. And we did. We made 100 acres of gardens and forests within the complex and outside the complex or adjoining the complex. So that's 100 acres of gardens and forests are there even today. So that's one plot. Then the roads which were there. Malabar Hill had good roads because we have the chief minister there, we have the governor there. So all the roads were always well maintained. So we decided we must have good roads. So we made good roads and we decided even to make concrete roads because we had to hand over to corporation. And we didn't want to hold the matter, delayed. So we made concrete roads. We did ducting, which was not so in the suburbs of Mumbai. We did stormwater drains to see that there's no water logging. So from the time we started in 1987 till today, there has been never any flooding in Powai, except I think a little bit during that maximum flooding time where we had flooding for about an hour. Otherwise, there's no flooding whatsoever in the whole of Powai. Every aspect of it was taken care of. Even in the case of buildings, what did we do? In those days, waterproofing was not a great idea. Plumbing always leaked. And these kind of thought processes were there. But my Malabar Hill house never leaked, neither the roofs nor the plumbing. So at that point of time, I think must have been 1987, 88, 89, I asked my chief engineer, who happened to come from one of the leading companies in Mumbai, from another developer's company, and he worked there for 15 years. And I told him, I asked him, in fact, I said, I want to make a building that doesn't leak, either the terraces or the plumbing. He kind of said, yes, sir, we will do it. Yes, sir, we will do it. And he walked out of the room and I could hear he was laughing. And I wondered why he would be laughing. Later, I came to know that he was laughing that this builder, this stupid builder, wants to make a building which doesn't leak. I mean, how can it be possible? All buildings and all buildings of all builders leak. How can it not leak? And that shocked me completely. So we terminated him and we got a whole team of young people. And fortunately, these young people, Mr. Pitala, the entire team of engineers with him, got into the complex. They were very young, but they were willing to learn. And we created an entire team of quality people. And of course, the person who really led this team was a person who's my brother, Surendra Hiranandani. He made huge and humongous efforts and spent a lot of time with Hafiz contractor in his office. In fact, I think Hafiz gave him a table or two on rent for 20 years. And he really spent a lot of time over there. So he'll have to clarify as far as that is concerned that, you know, Surendra spent so much time in his office in order to do all the work that he wanted to do in terms of the architectural part. So there were many ideas. Now, when we went to make a school, what was the difference? I studied in Campion School, a good school. It's today amongst the top two schools in Mumbai. I thought and decided that the Hiranandani School in Powai must be a better school, or at least the better school building at that time, than the Campion School that I have. And we made a better school building than that. Then we made a hospital. My father was a doctor in Jaslok, Reach Candy, Bombay Hospital, and other hospitals. Decided that the Hiranandani, the Dr. L. H. Hiranandani Hospital, named after my father, would be a better hospital than we would have anywhere in the city of Mumbai. And we did do that. Second, everything that we did within these complexes, we wanted to make it better than any other place. So we made a go-karting complex, one of the first, and a lot of children loved me simply because I didn't make good buildings, but I made a good go-karting track. And we had a go-karting track, we had a video game parlor, we had a game center. All these ideas were that you will make something which is quality conscious, which will be there. Funnily, one of the earliest buildings which Mr. Hafiz contracted made in Powai was the Lake Castle building. A huge building which gave us good name and gave Mr. Hafiz contractor international fame. Probably one of the first international awards received by Hafiz was over there. And that building I sold for 850 rupees a foot. Today it's selling at 45,000 rupees a foot resale. And it took me 2 years to sell the building. People were not ready to buy it. So they all said, you know, it's too expensive and why are you selling it at 850? But that's the story of real estate as it is. So the concept behind it, Vivek, is very simple. That I wanted to make something which was better, which should make me happy, which should make it beautiful. And of course, a huge part of this creative function was done by Hafiz. And that is why he will be able to lend as much, if not more, as to what went behind it. And what was the concepts which we created in terms of doing what it is. Our benchmark was simple. Our benchmark was to create a qualitative, appealing place. As you said and saw just now, lots of movies were shown over there. And people also realized that this made a world of a difference. So I'm very, very happy and proud that the people who live there are extremely happy because the buildings are well made and well maintained, and the area is still continues to be maintained. And I'm very happy that we are copied. Lots and lots of copies have been made by other developers and other architects. And I'm sure that people will eliminate, I mean, that itself is an indication that what we have done is good. I'm very happy that we will be able to leave this place for prosperity. And I'll end with only one thought. And I will tell Hafiz that I got an advantage. Because of him, I got some compliments. I went to an architectural school. I'm telling you a story of about 10, 12, 14 years ago. And I was introduced that Niranjan Hiranandani has built Pawai and it is there. And the young architect who was an intern actually, she must not have been a full-fledged qualified architect yet. She said that Niranjan Hiranandani, everybody in life creates history, his story, Niranjan Hiranandani's story. But Niranjan Hiranandani has created geography. And I was quite impressed with this young girl and actually pleased my heart that I even still remember it today. But Hafiz, you can see that the compliment was actually for you and I got it. So in reality, it is Hafiz contractor, rightly so, giving us the position of what he did and what he created. His life, his work, his humility, his hard work, his commitment to excellence, and his humbleness is huge. He may make 30 copies of a plan and you go and tell him that, you know, can you make a little change? Do you think it should be like that? He'll tear up his entire drawing and do it again. No big architect or great architects have the humbleness and humility which this great man has. And I really am happy that we have spent 30 years together. Is it 30 years? My God. 30 years together in terms of an association with a friend. Many times people say that, you know, we are almost married together. Maybe that's applicable more to Surendra and you than me and you. But anyway, we have been together for 30 years and it's been a lovely journey and a happy story. So congratulations, Hafiz, for the wonderful works that you have done. Thousands and thousands of works. For him, this is just one story. He has so many more stories to share. Hafiz, let's hear your story, at least this one story.
Thank you so much, Niranjan. That was very inspirational, but I'm sure it would have been a lot of perspiration as well.
Thank you very much, Niranjan. I really wish Surendra was also here today. But I remember the first time I was called by Surendra and you were in the cabin and we both were sitting outside, and that's how Surendra took my interview and we designed the first building, Beach Classic, for you in Warsaw. Okay, so the story of Pawai started with, I was called one day and, you know, after doing the Beach Classics, I was told that the Hiranandanis have a big plot in Pawai and they would like me to design one of the buildings over there. Pawai at that time was not known at all. I remember the roads were only 20 feet wide. You had to get down to one station or the other and drive over there. The whole site, as Niranjan said, was a barren quarry land with all dugout area. Finally, what we did later on, we transformed the whole hill and completely did a massive forestation program. And today, the whole hill It's completely green. You can't even recognize it. Okay. But as an architect, I was given a very, very narrow plot, and it was right at the back. And the hills were behind it. And the thing that was told to me was that, okay, this is the plot, and you have to design a building on that. And the aim was that each and every flat had to be looking at the lake. Up to that time, Pawai was not known. Niranjan and Surendra had made only those small bungalows. There was already some architect. And when I was given this job, I wanted to put Pawai on the real estate map. My aim was that I should do a building which should be top of the town, that everyone will start asking, oh my God, what a fantastic building. So at that time, we made a building which was 700 feet long, about 22 story high. And there were hills at the back, which I did not want they to be covered. So I made a building with large cutouts. That time they were about some 70 feet by 70 feet cutouts. And through that cutout, you'll be seeing the hill. And they became a talking point. Though there were only three flats of floor, but we saw to it that virtually each and every flat would be different. Some flat will have a deck, some flat, though it is two bedroom, will be slightly bigger, some three bedroom will be slightly bigger, smaller. So everyone is getting an exclusive flat. It is something different, which was, according to me, a marketing, a flaw. But that, to be very frank, I feel that caught on. I remember Anand Jain, he called me for the first time and he said, "Arey, kya building banaya hai? Kitna foot lamba, kitna foot ucha? Oh, do cutout mein se plane ja sakenga?" These kind of things started, and I feel that the Lake Castle put the Hiranandanis on the real estate map of Pawai. Though, as Niranjan said it, there were lots and lots of things. I remember I used to go with him to the MMRDA chairman, that time Mr. Subramaniam, and before that, Kakodkar. You're talking about road widths, how to increase the road widths and make it wider. And I must say that it was his hard work as far as the infrastructure was concerned. And it was Surendra's hard work as far as the quality and other things were concerned that really made where Pawai is. Once the Lake Castle was established, okay, and one day I remember Surendra coming to my office. When Lake Castle was going on, Surendra was not coming so often. But one day he came and he said that, "Oh, I would like you to design another sector." But he gave me a warning that, "Oh, I'm not going to do another building like Lake Castle, which is so expensive. You use a lot of glass, you use a lot of granite, this, that, that. I want an economical building." And he also said that, "Why are we making contemporary buildings?" And to me also, at that time, contemporary buildings would be costing more because of more glass, more of better and more expensive materials. So we started toying with lots of different styles. We did the postmodern, semi-classical, art deco, a Gothic style. And we kept on and on and on. And he kept on, saying, "Oh, this is not good. This is not this. This is not that." And finally, one day, I remember when he was there in the office, and I was literally, not knowing, now where shall we go? And suddenly one thought came to me, that I said that, why don't we make palaces for common man, an affordable palace? That line caught on. He said, what about that? And we came to a classical style. Mind you, today, we have so many buildings all over India, and a lot of architects, practicing classical style. But at that time, there was no classical style being established. The only classical style that was prevalent at that time were some dark bungalows or some old Lachin's bungalow in Delhi. But that was like, it was done so many years back. Now nobody could do it. Mind you, with that classical style, we made the first building. Before that, we started studying all the classical orders. I remember we used to, study column sizes, cornices, how to do those cornices, how to do these columns. And it was virtually for a year or so, we were studying classical architecture. At that time, mind you, concrete and what Niranjan just said, that all builders' buildings were leaking. And this was a common thing, that each and every building was leaking. And from the other side, I had started a movement called 2 feet 6 inches architecture, whereby what I was doing, I did all our external walls were 9 inches at that time. So what I did, I made all my external walls, instead of 9 inches, I made them 6 inches. So with that, I get a 6 inches of carpet area into my flat. And we were allowed 2 feet 6 inches projection, which was without FSI. So I made another 4 inches wall away from the building line by 2 feet six. So it became like a complete a raincoat. And with that, we could get our proper chhajjas, we could get our recessed windows, and the whole movement of 2 feet 6 inches architecture really became famous with Hiranandani's. Mind you, it was slightly more expensive, but either I give that 3 inches in the carpet area, or I reduce it, give the same size, and increase my sellability. So this 2 feet 6 inches architecture became very, very famous, and we practiced this for the one of the first times in Hiranandani Gardens. With that, no building was ever leaking, because there was a raincoat kind of a building on the outskirts, which protected the building in rainy season, and in summer, it kept it cooler. Once the classical style was established, then we started, making it a sense of place. Mind you, a lot of things today, we are saying that we wanted, and we did this, but a lot of this came about with a lot of hard work. The first element of public art, we started with the at the Rotary. We made a column in granite. We selected black granite, which was, the column was about more than 60 feet tall. Then we had to get a guy who will do kind of a granite column for us. We identified a guy from Jaipur, I still remember his name, Mr. Vishwakarma, and how passionately he did this column. Then we had to appoint artists to make the panels. There are brass panels down below. We represented those brass panels as the good life, representing Hiranandani Gardens, representing good life. And each and everything, as Niranjan said, you know, Surendra used to come to my office virtually every day. And mind you, he was also of a great help. He will come with every day with some book or the other and say, oh, I got this book from this British High Commission, you should read it. He would, though I was very, very passionate for with trees, and I used to tell him, oh, let's plant this tree and let's plant this tree. He came up with some really different trees which are grown in the Western Ghats and which are no longer, nobody was making the saplings of it. So we got them made. So the first thing started was after the first one or two buildings, then we made the first shopping center. The shopping center at that time, today I go to so many shopping centers and we have designed a lot of shopping centers. But today the trend is that everybody says, oh, we want an open air shopping center. We don't want air conditioning. We don't want this, but we want the ambience. We had done that nearly 30 to 40 years back. We created a street, we let the trees be there, we created the shopping center in such a way that each and every shop will have a small toilet, which was opening in a courtyard. They will be having a matka where they can have their own water. Now these kind of small things were talked about and designed. Once, you know, a few buildings were already there, people started living there. We had lots and lots of problems also with the initial tenants. Initial tenants always wanted to put grills. And I had seen in some of our early buildings in Pune also, that wherever we had insisted and not allowed grills, buildings were maintained and looked much better after a few years also. So we insisted over here that nobody should be allowed to put grills from outside. We had lots and lots of problems. I remember, you know, Surendra used to say, Niranjan used to say, Pithawala, and a lot of other people that, oh, people insist on putting grills. But with the effort of Hiranandani's, we did not allow. And today, one of the reasons why the whole complex and the prices and everything is higher, because once one of the chairman of Lake Castle or one of the managing committee guys of Lake Castle said that you insisted that there should not be any grills. We insisted on all our guys. And today we are realizing the benefit of that. Okay, once a little bit of the classical buildings came about, everybody started feeling that there was a difference. Now, mind you, classical buildings, we started with a purpose. Now, we felt that there was something in an aura was created. And we ourselves realized it. I realized it. And a lot of times when Surendra was telling me, oh, the next building, let us make it, you know, much more modern, or, you know, change the style. You know, he used to also say, oh, a lot of people are saying, let's change the style. But I said, no, please don't change the style. Don't change the style. If you change the style, then you will be in competition with each other. Keep that same style, make a sense of place and an ambience, which every time there was a little bit of back and forth, but I could convince her and make the same style. To get this classical elements, all we had to design all our shuttering. Hiranandani gardens or Hiranandani builders, by that time, it had become like virtually a research center. Every new material that we used to get, we would be doing, when I say we means the Hiranandanis would be doing a complete research on it. When we started Lake Castle and we had to cast large spans, the Hiranandanis employed a person called Mr. Remedius. He was a concrete expert. And mind you, with his help, concrete in Hiranandani gardens and concrete with Hiranandanis was a different element. The way other builders were casting concrete and the way Hiranandanis were casting concrete was completely different. It was really a proper, proper concrete, because how to mix, how much of water ratio, how much of slum, everything was properly advised, and all the engineers were properly trained by Mr. Remedius, Pithawala, then, you know, who's this, that South Indian gentleman, you know, but tall guy, I forget his name. He, then, you know, other new materials that we came about, we started all our grills in the whole complex. We wanted that all the grills should be virtually of the same material. The boundary walls, we kept it same. We had all our boundary walls in Malad stone. We started using tinted glass for the first time after a few buildings. For all our residential buildings, we started using tinted glass. Copper pipes, because at that time, all pipes, we were having, you know, GI pipes. And GI pipes, however you do your proper protection, in 10, 15 years, they will start corroding, or maybe earlier, they will start corroding, their joints would start opening up, and you will have leakage. So we, the Hiranandanis, spend the extra money, and copper pipes were started. In-house shuttering design of concrete and shuttering was done in-house. I remember at that time, we used to have panel walls, and the panel walls were of brick. We started importing bricks from Goa. For the first time, we started using fly ash. No other builder was using fly ash. We started using fly ash. And before any, today everyone and everyone is talking about, we are going to do a sewage treatment plant. Hiranandanis were the first guys, before anybody even uttered a word of sewage treatment plant, they established a large sewage treatment plant. And on top of the sewage treatment plant, we made a lake. I remember at that time, when this lake was open, to all the people from neighborhood would come in the evening to enter that lake, because we had boating also. And it became so famous that I remember, I think, afterwards, we had to restrict the people. After restricting the people also, there were still so many people. Then I remember, I think Niranjan, we were charging some 1 rupee or God knows something like that. But still, what I'm trying to say that the Hiranandanis and Pavai was just not a building site. It was like a research center. Then came, I remember at that time, the only offices were at Nariman Point. There was no BKC, there was nothing. BKC had just started when I made my first building. ILFSL also was much, much, much later. offices had to be Nariman Point. And Hiranandani started talking with Bayer and Camtex, and they were willing to come to Hiranandani Gardens as their next headquarters. Because by this time, the ambience had set, lots and lots of foreigners started living there, and it became a destination for offices. And the first offices were Chemtex. I remember Bayer, Mr. Brannerzer was the guy who selected me as to do up that building. And there's a very nice story about that also, but that I can tell you some other time. So the office complex came about. And these were a small beginning of small office. The Bayer was, I think, 1 lakh square feet. Chemtex also was some 75 or 80,000 square feet. And some many, many small offices started there. Okay. We started investing in street art. We went to Mahabalipuram. We got large sculptures. We started putting them in the gardens. Then all the first Rotary, we did the column. The second Rotary, we did some another sculptural piece. We had our own horticulture department, whereby we used to have our own nursery. We made a forest at the back of the Hiranandani, you know, this lake castle. We created a forest and planted each and every tree which we thought was not in that area. We planted baobab trees, we planted neem trees. We got squirrels from, we went and bought squirrels from this market and put squirrels over there. We wanted the Hiranandani garden to be a place where it will be a vibrant forest, vibrant garden with species, birds. We planted different type of trees on all the streets so that they look different, they flower at different times. After the office park, then the most important thing, and I think without that, Pawai would not have been successful. One is, you know, that creating the road in front of the Pawai, which connected right from the L&T junction to the Pawai station. The entrance halls we created, the entrance halls were really, you know, superbly done. And anybody who came to those entrance halls, beautiful clubhouse, which set the tone for anything, you know, which. And finally, we changed when we did this sector, we had to change some roads so that, you know, we get a large garden. And I feel that today also, when anybody talks about Pawai, it's a place which I feel that I'm really proud of. And I remember once when Times of India had a survey done that what kind of an architecture you like in Mumbai. Some person said, oh, I like the architecture of VT station. Somebody said something. One or two, you know, guys also said that, oh, we like the architecture of Kanchenjunga. But mind you, 75% of the people said that we like architecture of Pawai. They did not know that it's classical or it's Roman or whatever it is. But they said, we like architecture of Pawai. Now this is, I would say, is the story. A lot of things I must have forgotten because it has taken so many years and years to do it. and there were lots of ups and downs, and we surmounted all of those in a very nice way. And finally, what is the result, which, as Niranjan said, that it's going to be the geography. So this is what it is, and it is for posterity to stay. Thank you.
A question for Niranjan. If you were to create this all over again, what would you have done different? What would you do differently? Your mic is on mute. You just will unmute there. Thanks.
Hindsight is a very good thing to do, and always say that how you could have done it better. But it's never like this. So what you really do is look forward to create new things which could be even better than what you did before. So whether you make another township, whether you do another road, whether you do another hospital, whether you do another school, whether you make another institutional building, it's actually got to be better than what you did yesterday. So the point is not, Vivek, of what it is that you would do different. Obviously, everything changes, and opportunities are going to be different tomorrow than they were yesterday. And it's always like that. What Hafiz clearly told us is that we changed according to the situation. So what was there in 87 was not there in 89, 90. What was not there in 95? We did commercial, we did retail, we did IT. We created buildings on the hills. We changed the entire dimensions to look at IT with a different way. We didn't take anything for granted. So whenever we did anything correctly, not only did we look at the architectural part, or we didn't look only at the qualitative part, but ultimately, you have to remember that we looked at the end customer. So the customer should be happy. He should be getting a quality product. It should be endurable. It should have aesthetics. It should remain forever. One of the beauty of Hafiz's architecture, which he gave us, was that it is timeless. Many times you look at a building which is 10 years, 15 years, 20 years old, and you realize, oh God, this is a 20-year building that I'm staying in. Today, people can't make out a new building in Powai and an old building in Powai, which is 25 years old, because both of them look equally old or equally new. So that's the advantage of creating what I call a perennial architecture, an architecture which survives beyond the times. What is it like when you look at VT, when you look at the Municipal Corporation building, or the Prince of Wales building, or what you look at in Powai? You create something which is etched forever. So the issue is, Vivek, to answer your question, is really everything would be different because the needs are different, because the requirements are different. But in terms of architectural style, sure, we could have chosen so many other styles. Hafiz showed you at least 6 or 7 of them on the screen. We could have chosen any one of them. As long as they had something to contribute in terms of a perpetuity which lasts forever, that is what is important. So you look at this layout which you're seeing just now in terms of the background in front of the hills. The issue is not about the question as to which should be the style of architecture, but does it etch something which gives you happiness and satisfaction by looking at it? Is it livable? Is it affordable? Is it something which you would love to stay in, whether on rent, whether on occupation, whether to work in or to do it and have a pride of place? So I think all that becomes more important. The style of architecture which Hafiz does in different places and for different locations are different. For instance, one question which has come up is, what do you think of glass architecture? Glass architecture is glass architecture. It is an engineered building rather than an architect building. Of course, nowadays they play with glass too. So you get lots of buildings which may be glass, but they have an architectural concept behind it. But I mean, it's only a question of what you like. And I personally like what we did. So it's only a matter of choice. Different people wear different clothes. Somebody likes a t-shirt, somebody likes a shirt, somebody likes a Modi jacket, somebody likes a safari. So the kind of envelope that you create will be different. But ours is perennial.
Thank you. Hafiz, I'm sure everybody, and we have a lot of designers, a lot of architects who are watching you today, would loved your presentation. I mean, even though I know you well, I haven't myself seen this presentation. It was absolutely, absolutely amazing. The question I want to ask you is that if there are developers who have large tracts of land, what is one or two things that they tend to forget that are critical to township development?
See, the first thing for any township development, how to create a sense of place. That is the most important thing. If you create a sense of place, then it is like, you know, you may do an ordinary building also, you may do absolutely a fabulous building also. In a fabulous building, you spend much, much more money. But if you create a sense of place with a small, small ordinary buildings also, or the size is not the criteria, that will go a long way. And what is liked by a lot of people at Pawai is the sense of place. The other day, I was with one client and his chief architect. When I went to meet him, he says, "Arey, boss, I'm warning you, please, I don't want any physical buildings." So I said, "Okay." Then I asked him, "Where do you stay?" He says, "Oh, I stay at Pawai in Hirandani Gardens." So I said, "Why do you stay at Pawai in Hirandani Gardens? You don't want me to do the same architecture for you." Don't, not that I would have done it. So it's like this, a lot of architects feel that it is below their dignity to do classical architecture because this is not taught in the in the colleges, but they love it. It's, why do you love Paris? Paris, you know, it's a sense of place. So it's the same thing, and that is the most important. Then how you do other things, how you make the road, the streets, the services, yes, it is there. But you have all that, but if you don't have sense of place, you'll be lost. And the ambience.
Niranjan, what do you think? If you were to advise some developer, what are a couple of things that are critical that most developers forget in a large township?
Vivek, it's extremely difficult. It's like saying, how do you make a good tile? It's as difficult as that. But long and short of it is, I think a sense of commitment, a sense of honesty, a sense of integrity, a sense of creating something where you are happy to stay, which you feel as a sense of belonging to yourself. I mean, whether it's a small flat or a big flat in Pawai or in Thane or any of the projects that we create, I would be happy to go and stay in any one of them. So it's a kind of a feeling that, yes, this is good enough for me. And so why not it be good enough for anybody who wants to buy an apartment? So I think you look at the customer from the point of view that you're not giving him a live, bed, kitsch, but you're actually giving him a home. Once you think of it that way, then you realize, what would you give to a home? Would you not give him good streets? Would you not give him a garden? Would you not give him the facilities? Would you not give him a good waterproofing? Would you not give him aesthetic? Would you not give him a good school, a good hospital, a good facility, and other things? So I think once you have that sense of commitment to the thing, it and logically follows. Today, look at it. You buy a car. The car may be just costing, a Maruti would be what, 4.5, 5.5 lakhs of rupees. You still get a quality product. You may not get a fancy car. like you have, but you'll definitely get a car which works, which travels, which can do it and can take you from place to place. So it's not about the price of a product. It's about something that you deliver in a totality of service that you give to the end customer. If you think about it that, and you go beyond yourself in order to make that commitment, I think you can create beautiful spaces, as Hafiz has just described. The idea is you create a space because you are going to die one day, but these spaces are there forever. And that posterity is going to enjoy that spaces. Whether they remember you or not, it's not important. What is important is that you get a sense of satisfaction that you have created those spaces which will live beyond yourself.
The other thing, Ranjan, everybody would be interested to know, the location, like, it was never considered premium. It was considered out of the way, far from the railway station. That, how did you manage to create a premium, convert it into a premium location and manage to make buildings that were premium and charge premium prices for it?
That's a very, very good question, because even I didn't know how I did it, because I went and sold all these buildings bloody cheap to all the people. And lots of people came there to a far distant place where they didn't want to come because it was cheap. So the first people came to me because they found it economical, viable, and worthwhile. And later on, when the quality improved, the price appreciation did take place. But more and more people realized that we were making something which is very, very beautiful. The price factor is never in your hands. That is a market condition to do. So many times people say, how do you charge A price or a B price? That's market driven. It's not driven by me. It's driven by the state of the economy, the demand for the place and other things. And that's the situation that will be. Unfortunately, the developers today don't study markets. And they make products because Hiranandani is making it, or Godrej is making it, or Rustamji is making it, or Kalpathru is making it. So what has happened is we do a copycat of what other people are doing. In reality, it's all market driven. And the builders are now learning that they have to study the markets. It's not about what you create that's going to be selling tomorrow. It's going to be what market demands is what is going to happen. Same thing happens in the making of tiles for you or any other product that anybody is making. The builders thought that they were beyond that and they didn't have to worry about the markets. I think the truth is coming to us that now you're market driven and you have to follow the market in order to do so. So it's not me who make the price. It's the product and the market which makes us what we are.
But I'll add up to this. What Niranjan said, the other thing which was coming out distinctly was that in Pawai, we created all our gardens. All the road trees, the way they were planted, we started using all our sewage water for all gardening. So the gardens were always nice and green. We had two colored pipes. The sewage treated water, which was used for gardening, was one color, and the fresh water was one color. So the gardens, the streets were different, the street art. Then all the boundary walls were, you know, of one type. So when a person was moving, he would be feeling that he's moving in one area. And all of that, little, has added, though Niranjan is saying, and which is very true, that, you know, finally it's the market. But I feel that all the little things which were created, which has definitely given an edge in the market and the pricing. And I, you know, today, I don't go to Hiranandani Gardens every day, but Niranjan goes every day. So every day he must not be feeling it, but today when recently I had gone there, I was feeling so happy. It's completely different than any part of Mumbai. And that makes a lot of difference.
There's one more thing which I think we can add to the whole story. We did everything before its time. So when we made the building like Lake Castle, it was ahead of its time. When we did concrete roads, it was the first private layout which had concrete roads. We did the largest sewage recycling plant in India in a private layout in Powai, which is more than 4.5 million liters per day recycling 25 years ago. Now, today it's made compulsory for layouts to do sewage recycling. But we did it 25 years ago when it was not even required. So we always had water for our gardens, for our flushing and all those things. And these have now become precedents. One more thing I must tell you, that with Surendra and Remedios, they worked out concrete quality required. And we actually preceded the National Building Code changed on the basis of what Hiranandani's were doing in Powai for the buildings over there in terms of the qualitative engineering that we took up. When we made the swimming pool in Powai, the first one over there, it was very beautiful and considered. Lots of people now do it. But at the time when we did it, not many did. When we put up the school in Powai, not many developers did it. And we are very happy to see that many of the builders now follow it. When we put up the hospital in Powai, I think only the Raijas had, as a builder, had done it before us. So we set the precedent and we were number one in terms of doing all these amenities. And the rest of the people are following us. It has set a precedent for the developing community to actually emulate this example. And I'm very happy that they do. So whether it's the design, whether it's the quality, whether it's the finish, I think the reputation of the entire building industry has come up in terms of the quality, in terms of amenities, of what we are actually delivering. Of course, there are bad sheep in the line, but I can see a lot of good developers who have come up. Both the individuals, both proprietary, both corporate are now in the building industry, which was not there when I started.
Okay, last question from me before we open the questions to was there any inspiration, Niranjan, that made you do this in the way you did it?
Well, to be honest, there can't be just one inspiration. Multiple people who inspire me. Your father was one of the persons who inspired me. He always taught me how I should deal with people. Dr. Maker's father, who made the buildings at Nariman Point, I realized that the buildings made by Maker, by this Dr. Maker's father in Nariman Point, were different than the other buildings. And look at the difference. When he made the building, it sold for the other building sold for 145 rupees a foot. He sold it 175. Ultimately, today, the difference of the selling price or the market price of those buildings are more than 10,000 rupees a foot difference between A and B. I had looked up to the Rahejas, who at that point of time led the race in terms of projects that they did in Bandra, Khar, Santa Cruz, Versova. Then it was the Lokanwalas who actually showed me the way. The Singapore Development Authority, I visited that 25, 30 years ago. The townships they made, of course, really gave me an idea of how townships were made. So there wasn't just one guru. There was Mr. Remedios. There were so many people whom you look up to in terms of ideas and thoughts and over there. And why do we have to go far when you have a Hafiz contractor? You learn such a lot from him. And I had a very hardworking brother, Surendra, who did a lot of work. We have a good team. In terms of an architectural team at the back end, we have a good engineering team, we have a lot of support team. So all the teams in the Hiranandani family, the extended family of Hiranandani, have actually gone to make these products sell, products construct, and actually deliver the things in time. And Hafiz mentioned about the tall person, Mr. Nayak, who works with us. You mentioned about him and we're trying to struggle for his name. So we have that. We have internal architects. We have Gunisha who does, Sharmishta who does internally. Lots of people who do and participate. So it's a big team now. The Hiranandani family has grown into a huge thing. I'm the face of it. But reality, there is a big team.
We have Lots of questions, but we don't, of course, have the time for all of them. We'll take maybe five questions. Anika, the most important questions that you think will you ask, or somebody wants to come into the room to ask?
Okay, I'm going to start by asking a question to Dr. Niranjan Hiranandani. What was the thought process behind choosing Architect Hafiz Contractor as your architect for this project? How did you decide on that? And what were some of the technical challenges faced with respect to approvals, sanctions, things like that for this project?
The first question is easy to answer. As he mentioned just now, we used him for creating our first building, Beach Classic. And those who saw it realized that it was a unique building that he designed. And before that, we had seen two of his buildings, one at Kemp's Corner and one at Worli. I think both of them were very unique in character and quality. And we really emulated that idea. So we took him in for Beach Classic. And when we completed Beach Classic, I think we had developed an understanding of what Hafiz could deliver. As I told you, this man is very flexible, but very creative. Had qualities which were beyond normal architects would have. That willingness to work tremendously hard and overnight deliver lots of plans and papers and all. A commitment which not many people do. I wish I could also emulate his example of doing everything overnight, the way he does and creates the work. So choosing Hafiz at that point of time probably would have been surprising for many. But in reality, I was also looking for a young team. And at that time, he was young. Now, we are both quite grown up. I won't say old. So it's a lot of fun here having worked together. But we've actually grown to be a greater family, friends. And more than anything else, I must tell you that we have become very, very, very close. And very few people have as close a relationship as I have with Hafiz.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. Okay, we can let in a few of the people who want to ask questions. Chetan, can you let Mahesh Manik in so he can ask his question? Mahesh, you can unmute yourself and direct your question to our panelists. Chetan, you can let in Rakesh Agarwal.
Okay. Just that, you know, I think they're not able to do it. So I think that you
question in the meantime. This is directed to Architect Hafiz. What were some of your principal concerns while making the master plan, and what was your thought process behind the designing?
See, today we are talking about master plan and. Doing master plan evolve virtually every day, and today we are looking at virtually the finished product. To change one road also, we had so much of problem. Changing anything, we had tremendous problem. Some of the roads were already there. We have to just adjust with the roads. And I would say that the master plan came about with a lots and lots of effort on years and years. And as far as master plan is concerned, I would say that it was Niranjan who was playing a very, very, very important role. As Surendra was playing role of, you know, getting into the small things like the window detail and door detail and what kind of a faucet and what kind of a pipe. On a larger scale, it was Niranjan. Road widths. So it has gone through a lots of iterations. And finally, what you see is not just one day's thought, and it is not one day that, you know, the whole land was also not at this completely there in the initial time. Niranjan took some other land after a lot of years. Then he added up something. changes in MMRDA rules. So it's a long, long story.
Thank you. Rakesh, you can ask your question now. Please unmute yourself. Rakesh?
I think it's not working out. I think just ask the question to yourself. People are finding it.
No, sir.
Yeah, we can hear you. Please ask.
Hello?
Yes, Rakesh, please ask your question.
I have no question. I've got my answer.
Okay, I'm sorry. I'll ask a question to Dr. Hiranandani. How is the product mix decided for the Powai Township, residential, retail, office, etc., since the market there was completely non-existent?
In the first phase of activity, we concentrated on one bedroom, two bedrooms, and three bedrooms. But the three in the sector, which was the Eden sector, but the three bedroom were maybe 5% of the total product. Most of the product was one bedroom and two bedroom. In the subsequent buildings, we moved up to two and three building, the three bedrooms. And later on, of course, we went from one to five. So we now make one bedrooms, we make two bedrooms, we make three bedrooms, four bedrooms and five bedrooms. But of course, the product mix keeps on changing depending on what is the absorption of the market. So it's really market driven, but we kind of sometimes bench ahead of the market. So the time when we made four bedroom flats or five bedroom flats, nobody in the whole market of suburbs ever dared to make a four and five bedroom building. We dared to do so. So those were the type of products which we call ahead of the market. So that requires a lot of guts to do. But the rest of it, which is the one bedroom, two bedroom, three bedroom, were benchmarked as to what the market requires. But then out of the entire product, we did create a couple of buildings, which actually went out and did it. In the beginning, we found it extremely difficult to sell. But later on, the demand is huge. In fact, today, the larger flats have a premium of almost 25% of what the other flats sell. So a larger flat not only has a bigger area, but the price component is 25% higher. So those are the things which keep on happening. You have to have the guts to sometimes be an anticipate of the market, but you can't be foolish. You have to be sensible in terms of that type of approach also. Normally, I would recommend to everybody to benchmark with the market, study what the market demands are, and then move ahead into the market. Sometimes you must innovate, and especially if you have a Hafiz contractor with you.
So as you said, that even though you were making good buildings, at the beginning you had to sell cheap to get the people into that location till you could actually charge higher. This is what you had to do originally to start with.
Yeah, but that is for every brand. Any brand that you create in the world, the brand always at the initial stages of entry would have to pay, would charge less. So for example, in Barsova, when we made Beach Classic, there was a building made by Mr. Lokanwala. I remember we were selling at 950 and he was selling at 1350. Ultimately, at the end of the product, we were selling at 2500 and he was selling at 1600. So ultimately, though the brand did have a premium at that time, and he was a brand and I respected him for it. I looked up to him in many respects, Mr. Shiraz Lokanwala, he's no more, but I still must say that I respected him a lot. But the problem is that if you don't make products which are consistent and good and qualitative, then the brand has no meaning. So over a period of time, you lose the premium value, or at least the customers will not be able to get the premium value. So you have to consistently being good in order to see that not only you command a premium, but also that the customer satisfaction is immense. And that is what I think the goodwill of Hiranandani's comes about.
Last couple of questions, Anika.
Okay, so we have one question directed to architect Hafiz. If the same space was given to you again today, what would be different in your style in today's context, looking at Mumbai skyline, current skyline?
I think it's not a diplomatic answer, but I would really say that I would like to do same style, but I wish I can start with today's, you know, what is established at where Hiranandani Garden is there today, and take it much, much ahead. I remember we always were talking about making a hotel on top of the hill. With today's market and all that, we would make the hotel on top of the hill and make such an iconic hotel that not only it will become a superb building, but a great place to go there, see the view, and also see the whole township. I would do the roads a little bit wider. I will make the streets a little bit more, but they are very, very friendly. But would now, if I had my way, I would break through the residential area, a little bit more of shopping. And whatever we have learned, I would put it more into it. But I will definitely make it physical. I'll definitely use the same kind of, you know, materials. This I have mentioned about Renova. The other day, I was told that one of the building guys wanted to paint again, and they called that guy, and he just took a hose pipe and said that there is nothing wrong with your paint. It's the dirt on top of it. So he just put the hose pipe, and the whole area was completely new. So what we have done it with a lot of research. So I think that I will just take that thing forward. And that would be the right thing. So what I can say that whoever is staying in Pawai can really be very, very happy that there were people who really thought of it, who really felt. I remember I used to go each and every Sunday, and the whole Sunday I would spend there. So it is with that kind of a love, and both the Hiranandani brothers also would be there. So it's with that kind of a love and affection that the whole complex has come about. And that really makes it good and great. So I would do it again.
There's a question from the participants. Any advice for young architects or developers?
Hafiz?
See, nothing happens just by a fluke. That each and every Sunday, not only that other days, but each and every holiday, night and day of work, dedication, and also love and affection, and a complete commitment that has given rise to a project like this. Complete commitment and complete dedication. And it's not just from architect. It starts with the builder. Any building, anybody likes it, okay? It is not just one person. I would say it is 30% is the client. 30% or more than 30% was the client, then the contractor who constructs it. And I would say that it is only last 30 or 25 which is left is the architect. Because we have designed lots of buildings because not of good, because the builder is not good. The building goes down. The contractor is not good. The building goes down. So you first need a good client who's dedicated, then a good contractor, and then You'd be lucky to have both of this. And then if the architect doesn't create a good building, then he's a fool.
Any advice from Niranjan?
Well, many times people say that I did my best, but it has not come out well. I think I remember my guru, Dada J.P. Vaswani, my spiritual guru who's no more. And he told me on one of his birthdays that it is not good enough to do your best. You got to do your best and a little more. So I think that is what is required by all of us to really do it. And the second thing which I believe in is that many people say, I like my work. And that something is never going to make you into a project like Pawai is, or an architect what Hafiz is. You got to actually love your work. The people who like your work can never become extraordinary, because they just like it. And you can like so many things. But if you actually love the work that you're doing, whether it's a project like Pawai from a builder's perspective, or a designing work like Hafiz does, or products that Vivek, you do in Nitco, it's a question of passion. The moment you love your thing and you love your work, there's no way by which it cannot come out beautifully. Thank you, Vivek. I have another meeting to attend to. So okay, thank you very much.
The last small question, something to say to Hafiz. Something you would like to say to Surendra, left us, gone, and lives in London, doesn't live in Bombay anymore. Anything you'd like to say to him? He might be listening to us, or he will listen to you, what you say.
I miss him tremendously. I wish he was here, and I wish he was there for this program. And that's about all. I sincerely miss him, in the office. That's it. The time has, life has to keep on going. That's about it.
Okay, thank you so much, Hafiz and Niranjan. It was superb, fantastic, very inspirational for everybody, including me, who know you both so, so well, and loved it. And see you soon. Thank you so much once again.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Niranjan. Thank you, Vivek. Thanks, everybody.
Thank you.